When working as a developer, when writing code, there are certain principles you might want to keep in mind and follow. Something like the dry principle, the don't repeat yourself principle, but also, for example, the kiss principle, the keep it simple, stupid principle. And that's a principle I want to take a closer look at today. Because it's fairly easy, especially if you're maybe a less experienced developer, to write unnecessarily complex code. And it's not just the code complexity, but I'll get back to other forms of unnecessary complexity later. Let's start with the code complexity. Especially if you're not that experienced, maybe, it can be quite tempting to introduce a lot of unnecessary abstractions in your code. It can be quite tempting to think, well, what if I also maybe need to use a certain function or a certain piece of the code base in a slightly different way in the future? And all of a sudden, you start making a function that did one specific thing in the past more generic, so that it can do more things or accept more types of input, and so on. So it can be quite tempting to make your code more flexible so that it can handle more use cases and your code base gets more modular and more generic. And that's a good thing, right? We want a modular and generic code base. Well, not necessarily. If you're writing some code for a package that you plan to distribute as a third-party package to developers all over the world, then you might need some generic code or modular code. You might need to support a lot of different use cases, but even then, you might not need to support all the use cases you think you need to support. And especially if you're working on your own application, so if you're writing code for an app you built where you know what it should do, it really doesn't make a lot of sense to already think of all kinds of possible variations at the point of time where you're getting started. Sure, there always is a trade-off, and if your code is too specific, you might spend a lot of time refactoring that code if you eventually need to support different use cases, or if parts of that code need to get more flexible in the future. But on the other hand, if you write everything as generic and flexible and modular as possible right from the start, you spend a lot of time making your code base quite complex, and that then can actually also lead to problems in the future because it's now maybe not so easy to use it in the way you want to use it because you made it very flexible and modular, so you need to pass a lot of configuration parameters or stuff like that. So there actually is a trade-off here. Modularity and flexibility can make sense, but it's not always what you should go for. And I guess you can kind of like draw a bell-shaped curve, where on the left side of the bell, where the curve is very flat, we have beginners who write very simple code that's not very flexible and modular because they don't know that they might need more modular code or they're not able to write more generic and flexible code. But then we go on top of that bell, so we go up that curve, if that curve depicts the complexity of the code base, and we suddenly start writing pretty complex code because we feel smart about it, because we write code that supports a lot of different use cases and input parameters, and we suddenly end up with that very complex code base, which we don't need for the project, or which we might not need for the project we're working on. And we introduce new problems along the way, and of course, if we write very complex code, we also spend more time solving a specific problem because we don't just solve the problem, but we also think of future problems, which we also try to solve already. So it takes us more time to write the code to get a certain job done because we try to make that code as flexible and modular as possible. Well, and then we go down that curve again as we get more experienced, because as you get more experienced as a developer, you learn, well, that you might not need the most generic and flexible code base in all situations. That in a lot of situations and scenarios, it's fine if you just write good code that solves a specific problem and doesn't try to solve all kinds of problems you might be facing in the future. If you then evolve your code base so that you need to solve another problem, you can still make parts of your code more flexible and modular, but even then you might just make it as modular and flexible as needed to solve the original problem and maybe now another new problem you need to solve. So even then you might not go down that route to make it as modular and as flexible as possible. And that is a really important lesson to learn, that you don't need to look smart when writing your code, that you don't need to try to solve all possible kinds of problems with your code base, and that instead it's often better to keep the code simple, to keep the code base simple. And by the way, simple code does not mean bad code, not in any way. Instead, simple code means that your code solves a certain problem and it does that well. And of course, it also does that in a way that handles potential errors that might arise and so on, but it's not getting unnecessarily complex. And that is a skill that simply comes with experience. It is something you can learn by always questioning your code, by always being critical and asking yourself, do I need to make this code more generic, more flexible, or should I keep it simple? Is it simple enough? Does it do what it should do, and does it do that well? Or am I trying to do more than I originally planned? Or is the code maybe not doing enough? Are there potential errors that might occur that I'm not handling? You always have to question your code, and of course it also helps if you're not working alone, but in a team. If you got a colleague or a friend who reviews your code and who gives you input on your code. Because there is the danger of writing bad code because it's too simple, too focused on one specific problem maybe. But in my opinion, there is an even bigger danger of writing bad code because it becomes too complex, because it tries to do too much. Now, as I mentioned originally at the beginning here, it's not just the complexity of the code base that matters and that you should keep an eye on. It's also a complexity regarding the technologies you might use. Because, for example, if you're building a blog website, your own personal website, which should contain a blog where you plan on sharing some posts about your life or some tutorial posts, whatever, you could just create that blog with a content management system like WordPress. You could also build it on your own, of course, with some static site generator, with something like AstroJS, for example. But you could also just build it as a Node.js or PHP-based website where you store your blog post data in a database and you render that as HTML documents then. You could do all that and that would all be fine. But you could also start building a complex application where you have a standalone React or Angular or whatever single page application front end, and then a REST API backend or a GraphQL API, doesn't matter. You have some caching in between, a caching layer. You set up an extra database to which the backend communicates. You start bringing in a ton of extra third-party libraries into both ends, also in the front end to add lots of extra features that might not be too important for a blog, but that you feel like you need to have. Then you start hosting that block on AWS, and you want to do it with Docker and containers and also in some kind of serverless way. So you look into all the services you need to do that and so on. You see what I mean? You can build a simple block in a pretty complex way. And don't get me wrong, you can do that. It can be a great exercise. If you want to get better at working with Docker or with AWS or React or whatever, definitely start building demo projects. Build your blog that way, but only do it if you do want to practice certain technologies or services. Don't start building your blog like this if you just want the blog, if that's the main thing you want, if you don't care about the exercise, because you don't need that super complex tech stack. You don't need a super complex web application that consists of dozens of technologies and libraries and frameworks and so on, just to render some blog posts onto the screen of your website visitors. You don't need that. So here again, keep it simple. Don't introduce all those libraries and packages because you read somewhere that you need to use them. Instead, keep it simple. Use the simplest possible solution for achieving the goal you want to achieve, unless, as mentioned, you want to practice working with those technologies. Because then, of course, your goal also isn't to render blog posts onto the screens of your visitors, or at least that's not the primary goal then, but the goal then is to learn and grow. And then it's of course absolutely fine and the right thing to do to work with all those packages and services and technologies and so on. So then definitely do it. But if your goal is something else, if your goal is the end product, the blog or whatever it is, then you should keep your tech stack simple, because in that case, if you would make it unnecessarily complex, you would just spend more time unnecessarily on working on that project, and you would also make it harder to maintain, because if you come back to a super complex project in the future, it simply takes you longer to get back into it. And that's the case no matter if we are talking about a complex tech stack or if we're talking about a complex code base. So therefore, in a nutshell, keep it simple and don't think that it's smart or a sign of intelligence to use complex technologies or to write complex code. It's actually the opposite. A good developer uses the best and simplest code or tool to get a job done without doing that job in a bad way. So without ignoring important features the code should have or something like that. But adding unnecessary complexity, it's not something you want to do.